Hello everybody, this is Green Spirit. Welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to go ahead and go through my travel altar. This is a video that I had done previously, but it was really low quality. And so I've been promising that I would redo it, and this is me redoing it. I've also updated some of the contents in here, so it's a little bit more thorough. I'm going to try to do this video as quickly as possible because I do have a very limited amount of time in which to do it. So excuse me if I talk kind of fast. So this is my little travel altar. It's made of wood. In fact, this used to be a tool set that my little boy got several Yules ago for Yule. It had little wooden tools, and when I saw the box, I thought this would make a perfect altar. Of course, I didn't want to take it from him, but after a while he stopped using it, and so I decided to take possession of it. What I've done here is I've drawn out these poppies, and then I've gone ahead and wood burned around my line drawings, and then I painted it, and I really like how it came out and the colors. It comes with a little handle, which is nice, and then it's got two latches on this side. Okay. So then what happens is I can go ahead and unlatch it and open it. Trying to get some good light here. And then it comes with, I have a little bag here. And I'll go ahead and take that out so you guys can see. And then I'll go through what's in here. Okay. So here it is. This is my goddess section. Of course, it's Guadalupe, who's my matron goddess. All the little beads around her are rose quartz, except for the flower beads, which are just regular glass beads. One thing you'll notice about this altar is that all the images come from like Reader's Digest, except for a couple of scrapbook pictures. And mostly these are just crystals that I had or beads that I purchased. It's really an economical way to do this. So my little goddess section. Here's a little goddess charm, a bead. This little moon came from an old earring that I had. And a lot of this, like these used to, like there used to be holes right here. It's because tools used to be able to be put in the holes. So I had to plug the holes, and I used hot glue, and then I added different elements to it. This little faith charm came from Michaels. It came in a pack of different kinds, and you'll see some others in a minute. They're about $1.50, so I went ahead and added here some roses. And then this is a little like priestess or goddess. I don't know if it can focus. It's very detailed. This is called a Feves, F-E-V-E-S. It's made of porcelain. I believe it's the French. They have a festival where they put these little Feves into their bread, and they have all kinds, like any image you could possibly think of. I got it on Etsy, so if you want to look one up, you can. Over here is my earth element. Again, this is another image I found in Reader's Digest of a forest. The leaves, I wanted to add some texture, so I used some dried thyme from my garden at my old house. Here I have, so I can get some detail, I have some quartz crystal geode from a geode my husband gave me, a little rabbit because I've consider them an earth animal because they burrow under the ground, and a little bit of bark. And then I'm going to try to shift this. Okay, here we've got the ocean. Again, another image from Reader's Digest. I've added a little fish bead, actual shell, a little sand dollar. That's an actual little sand dollar, a little seahorse, and then a little tiny piece of coral. Coral is actually something that you cannot harvest anymore, so I don't know if this is a specific kind of coral that they got at the bead store, but you can't really harvest it anymore. This is my god section. I had a little green man bead that I was going to use over here, but I decided against it because it didn't go with like the aesthetic that I wanted to go through. What I did for the god is I put like an image of a canyon, which I thought was very appropriate. And then it has a little charm that says "All good things are wild and free" by Henry David Thoreau. I added a little pine cone, a little bead. It was part of a brooch, but this is a little maple leaf. a little sun bead, and then a little acorn, and then I added a little stone that I found. And stones that have white lines through it are very powerful stones, so keep an eye out for them. This is my air section. Let's see if I can focus here. What I've done here is I've gone ahead and gotten a picture of hot air balloons, and I've added some little birds, and I'm going to put this down because I want to show you guys something. I'm going to put this down. Okay, so as you can see, this is my wand. I've left a space here to hold my wand. I'm going to put this down so I can remove my wand. And it just holds it perfectly in place so that my wand can travel with me. I'll show you the little hole, how I plugged it in with hot glue. But it allows me to hold my wand and protect it. And then if you notice here, this is all cotton that I added for clouds. Okay. All right. And then here is my fire one. This paper came from scrapbook paper, and what this is essentially, I've got little heart beads all around, a dried rose petal, which came from my wedding bouquet, I've got a little, chili pepper, which is fiery, I created a little bonfire with some sticks and a little image that I drew of a little fire, and then over here, and I don't think we can capture what that little bead says or a little pendant says, but it says love, courage, and adventure, and then it's on top of a lava rock. So that's what it is. Over here I have my spirit section. There's an all-seeing eye, and then I left this open because I wanted to be able to put something in here, like you saw my bag and my little book, so that allows me to have that space. But also, if I wanted to bring along like an image of something that I'm working on, I could just prop it up here, which is nice. This section used to have these little wooden things that flipped out for the tools. I removed that, and now I've got two little shelves, which is kind of cool. Let me see if I can get some more light, guys, here. Okay. This is my spirit section. Obviously, there's a little pendant that says spirit on it. I have an abalone shell that I've had forever. I think I was maybe in high school, 14, 15 years old when I found that. And I finally am glad that I got a chance to use it. I've got a little skull bead that my husband gave me. And then I have a little hummingbird, which in my culture symbolizes spirit and the other side. So I've gone ahead and added that. All right, and now I'm gonna put you guys down so you guys can see what is in these little drawers. I'm gonna check my time here. Again, I'm working on limited time today. Okay, so what I have in these little drawers, I've got some embroidery floss with a needle for knot magic or anything that I want to work with that involves this kind of thread. I did it in every color you could possibly think of, from pink to purple, white, brown, and all the other rainbow colors. And then I have just normal thread and needles, and then I got a couple of pins, again, for whatever I might need. I have some incense. These are match incenses. Right now I have patchouli in here. And then in here I have some salt. And this is cornmeal for an offering. And if you notice, these little containers are from my, like, what is it, food coloring. And I've just saved them. The other ones are still being used, but once they get emptied, I will use them for something along these lines. Probably I will carry some water. So that's it in that. Actually, let me put that back so I can pack this as I go. Okay, next thing in here. Okay, so remember, yes, if you've watched my other video, I had a little cast iron cauldron that I intended to put in this altar. Guess what? It doesn't fit. But this is what I've been using, and I think it's going to be just fine. This came from the top of an oil burner, and that is what I'm using as a cauldron. And if you can see, it just pops up there. I went ahead and made some little dishes for my salt and my water. And here it is. I got a little shell. I added some moonstone beads to the bottom. And then that will hold my water. Here's a little one for salt. Again, did the same thing. Those are my little dishes. This is another Phoebe's. I ended up paying a little bit more for this one. They're relatively inexpensive, but this was a chalice and I'd never come across another one. So I paid a little extra for this, but I think it was well worth it. That goes up here. Okay. I've got a pair of scissors that are bendable because I think, I know sacrilege, but I think they work a little bit better than a bowline. So that's what I have in here. And then I have a key. Of course, keys like open things and they can symbolize opening new doors. But this is actually a little knife. And I usually pop that one in there. Okay, in here I've got, this is a little pill bottle from the dollar, I believe I got it at the Dollar Tree. It comes in higher tiers. If I ever needed an extra something else to put in here, I'll just add another tier to it. But all I have in here is different stones for pretty much every purpose you could possibly think of. I have an amethyst. Each one corresponds to one of the chakras, but they also have their own properties. So I could use them for crystal healing, I could use them from chakra work, and I can use them for just general spell work. So I've got an amethyst, a kyanite, a quartz crystal, a garnet, a peridot, lapis lazuli, rose quartz, tiger's eye, moonstone. I think that's all I got in here. But anyways, pretty much anything you could possibly think of. Those are your all-purpose ones. Next here, I've got sand, obviously, to put in my cauldron. Uh-oh, my battery's running low, guys. In here, I have a all-purpose blend. This can be used for any kind of spell you can think of. I chose herbs that pretty much anything that you could possibly need could be used. I use rose, mugwort, lavender, and rosemary. And then I have some chalk. Again, if I want to draw like a sigil or something, that's where that goes. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and open my bag. In my bag, I have a little bag that I made. Here's a cauldron and all the elemental symbols and the sun. Sorry, I'm going fast, guys, but this holds my pendulum and a little bell. Okay, I'm candles. These are birthday candles, and I've got a black chim candle because I couldn't find a birthday candle, but I also have birthday candles that are gold and silver. These I got at the dollar store, and then again I couldn't find a birthday candle that was white, but I have a little tea light candle. Next thing I have in that bag are papers. These are origami papers. My son got into origami. I cut them to shapes, a little square. And these are the colors of the rainbow. They're white on one side, so these can be folded into spells, burned, so on and so forth. But I got one for every color. This is a little broom I made. This comes from two brooms that I own. So I made it from both of my magical brooms. And I've also added some kyanite to this piece right here. So very protective. And then the red is also protective. Got a lighter. Here I've got some fabric. This is just like muslin fabric that I've cut into squares, again for whatever purposes. If I want to use my embroidery floss and embroider something, or make a little poppet, or whatever I want to do, or even, I don't know, whatever I want to do, I have some fabric in there. I've got a little offering dish. This is an angel wing. I got this at Michael's. I think I paid 50 cents. Candle holder. Little wooden spoons for scooping stuff like my sand and stuff out of my little container there. I have a little agate. that is where I put my cauldron on to protect the surface that I'm working on. I put a mirror. Oh, hello. I put a mirror to reflect if I put crystals on here, or, you know, mirror magic. And then I have just a little black sachet bag, you know, whatever I came across and I wanted to, you know, put away, that's what's in there. And then before I took out this little notebook will have it's for writing. I have a pencil that goes in here, but I don't have it in here right now. Essentially, write anything down, ritual outlines, spells, anything I come across, dreams, that's what that's for. And guys, that concludes my little miniature travel altar. It has everything that I could possibly ever need. I'm quite proud of this, and I'm really glad that I can pretty much carry everything that I need. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm sorry I spoke so fast, but if you did enjoy this video, please hit that like button. And if you really like this video, hit the subscribe button for any future videos for me. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and blessed be. Goodbye.